wasn't anymore the Maronites' priority, it's the Christian priority. All the Christians, Lebanese Christians all over the world are on the top priority of the Maronite Foundation. The second mission is to help them preserve and regain their Lebanese identity and nationality, to motivate them to participate in the political life of Lebanon. You will see now you will have many rights when you are Lebanese. Between them, the right to vote and the right to be elected in Lebanon. You will see it later. And to facilitate their return to their homeland, should they choose to do so. Many, many people from, unfortunately, from Venezuela and from South Africa and from many countries are now asking for the Lebanese citizenship to claim. They claim back their Lebanese citizenship because they are obliged to leave the countries where they are living. So another nationality is always a big, big gift. So we'll talk about it later. We'll have a workshop about the Lebanese nationality. Danielle has been working with us in Argentina since many years to motivate people to register. We'll see it later. We'll have a workshop about it. The objectives of the Maronite Foundation, the first objective is we are not working alone. We are working with all the ministries and the Lebanese government and the Lebanese administration. Our first objective is to coordinate, to create ties between the offices of the Maronite Foundation and the consulate all over the world. Just to help the Lebanese in the world registering their vital events in the official Lebanese civil registration. If you are not in the records of Lebanon, you are not Lebanese. You can claim that you are descendants of Lebanese, it doesn't make you Lebanese. You have to be registered on the official books in Lebanon, and we'll talk about it later. The objective of the Maronite Foundation, that's why we are participating to all conventions, to the LDE, the Lebanese Diaspora Energy, all over the world. We did it in São Paulo, we did it in South Africa, and next month we'll be in Las Vegas for a convention to sensitize the Lebanese to their political, cultural, economical, social, and social participation in the Lebanese public life. One of the objectives also is to promote Lebanese heritage, and you will discover yourself when you will be visiting the religious and the touristic sites in Lebanon. I'm sure Anthony will tell you about his experience with us. You will be in love with what you will discover and what you will see. So please take advantage of every minute with us. It is one life experience. You will not live it anymore with another. You will not have the chance to come back with us. Maybe you will come by yourself. The fourth objective is to encourage and facilitate expatriates to invest. Yes, to invest. Many of our academicians from the 2013, 14, or 15, and 16, many of them came back to Lebanon and have business. They had business in Lebanon. Of course, if you choose to do so, we can help you to invest and make business in Lebanon. About our offices all over the world, we have started our work in Europe with an office in France and an office in Sweden, and we will extend it next year to London because we have 5,000 Maronites living in London, and we are working hard to have a coordinator in Germany, so we'll have an office also in Germany because we have a lot of Maronites in Germany. We have many, many offices in USA. In every big state, we have a coordinator or a representative, and we have a board of trustees in USA. Mrs. Nada Abi Samra didn't arrive to Lebanon yet, but she will come and she will give you a special lecture about her office in USA. We have one office, officially office in Canada, in Montreal, and we have a coordinator in Ottawa. We have a coordinator in Toronto, but we are working to have an office in Ottawa and an office in Toronto. Who is from Ottawa? Okay. And from Toronto? Excellent. So you might be our coordinator there. So we'll talk about it. We have in Australia, and you are many from Australia. We have, everybody knows Mrs. Fatia Hussain. She is our director there. We have an office since last year in Melbourne, and we'll have another office in New Zealand. So we'll cover like this. And we have one of our students from Brisbane, Sean, and he is now with his father. They are our coordinators in Brisbane. We have many offices in South and Latin America, Brazil, Mexico, Venezuela, Argentina, Uruguay, Paraguay, Dominican Republic, and Ecuador. Dominican Republic and Ecuador, we have just coordinators. So people who are here from Dominican, we have two from Dominican Republic, one or two, two. And two from Ecuador, from Guayaquil and from Quito, isn't it? So we have to work together to see how we can promote more the registration there, because we have a lot of Lebanese there. We have in South Africa working very well. Richard, it's your duty for next year. And we opened offices with coordinators this year in Chile, Cuba, and Bolivia. So you can imagine how heavy is our duty, and you are doing this just to connect you to your country, to connect the Lebanese who are living abroad, because you are very, very well integrated, and you succeed very well. That's why we want you to be Lebanese and to be proud of your first nationality. The Maronite Academy, it was established a few years after the opening of the Maronite Foundation, and it was in 2013. Till now, we have more than 260 representative students like you who participated to our program. With your group, we'll attend 300. So we are now a big club, and we'll create a club for you. Daniel Assad, he started already with our office in Argentina for all the students from Latin America. I address you now, the first day of your program, to see if you from US or from Canada, from Australia, you are a big group already there. You have to choose someone like Daniel Assadi to promote and to motivate people to register at the Maronite Academy and to promote registration. We'll talk about it, but when you are together, please discuss between you how you can help and who could be the one who can contact everybody about this project. Australia, Canada, and US, because you are a big group here, and we have received a lot of students the years before. The goals of the Maronite Academy is to reconnect, the first one is to reconnect the ties between you, the descendants of the Lebanese living abroad, and you are millions there, you are millions, we'll arrive to this later, with your roots, with the roots of all the descendants in Lebanon. It's to strengthen not only the roots, to strengthen the Maronite heritage, and you will discover how rich is our heritage, and you will be proud to know from where your parents came. And especially the legal citizenship affiliation. As I told you, it's not enough to be descendant of a Lebanese. You should have your legal Lebanese affiliation to the land of cedars, and you will discover the cedars. And the third one is to promote Lebanon as the spiritual motherland of Lebanese worldwide. This is the duty of Father Fadi Kmet, who will put the priority on this objective. This is one of our photo for the class 2016. Okay. This is the class 2015 with this Beatitude de Patriarch, and you will have your photo next year with the group. 2014, this should be Farzibien or Faraya. And this is the first promotion, first class 2013. This is the gala dinner, and you will have the chance to have the same gala dinner on the 18th. I'm sorry, Anthony, maybe I have to rush. Okay. It's very important to highlight some facts in Lebanon. We have in Lebanon only 4,571,000 are registered on the official books in Lebanon. We have around 10 million, between 10 and 12 million, who are abroad and they are not registered in Lebanon. Would you imagine if 10% of the 10 million, if we are able to register 10% of them, the balance will change, the number of the population in Lebanon will change, and you'll understand one day after day that it's very important for us as Christians to be, the number be higher than this. The total Christians constitute, unfortunately, 34.96. We used to be 74%. Christian used to be in Lebanon, 70%. We decreased till 34% because the people who emigrated after the First War, the Second War, and the War of 75 neglect or didn't have the time to register their marriage and their children. That's why the number decreased from 74% to 35%, and will decrease more and more if you don't help us to register. That's why you are here. That's why we created the foundation. That's why people are paying the offices outside, my salary, the appointment of many, many people who are working with us to change this demography. The Maronites represent only 19% from the whole population and 55% from the Christians. We are still the majority between the Christians. The Greek Orthodox represent 6.8 from all Lebanese, the Greek Catholics 4.45 from all Lebanese, the Armenian 3% from all Lebanese. The total of Muslims constitute 64.64 or 2,954,000 Lebanese Muslims. They are our double, and we are living very, very well. We are the only country in all the Middle East and even all over the world where coexistence is very well respected, and we are cooperating very well together. But it's very important for you to know that the Lebanese children, that's why we are working hard to change this, because the Lebanese children under 10 years old represent only 13%. Can you imagine Lebanon in 20 years? The Christians will be only around 13%, which is really, it shouldn't arrive. The Christian children less than 10 years old represent 8.8% of the Christian population. And the Maronite children less than 10 years represent 10% of the Maronite population, because we are the majority between the Christians. If this trend continues, we believe that in 30 years or less than 30 years, Lebanon will have less than 24% of Christian population as total, as all. I prefer not to talk about the eligibility, because we'll have a workshop for 2 hours. You should know that in Lebanon, we have two censuses. One was made in 1921, and it ended in 1924. And the second one was done in 1932. The Lebanese law now considers the Lebanese only registered on the book 1932 as Lebanese. The others, those who, your grandfather, great-grandfather, your ancestors, who were registered on the census 1921, they weren't considered as Lebanese. We have about 1,100,000 of names on this census. The Maronite Foundation, since 2009, started to prepare a law with the parliament, with the government, to change this and to give the right to those, to your grandfathers, to your ancestors, those who are registered on the 21, to regain their Lebanese citizenship. We were lucky. In 2015, the law was voted and was ratified. And now, if all of you could claim again the Lebanese citizenship, if your ancestors are on the census. So now we have a lot to do because we have the two books to take it into consideration. How to do it? You have to visit. To contact one of our offices, and they are at your disposition. They know the people from Canada, they know how the office is working, they know of Australia, USA. You know that you are working a lot, especially in Argentina. The embassy or the consulate can help you and should help you to know more about your rights. And as I told you, the office of the Lebanese, of the foundation, we created with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs a special website for you to facilitate. We'll talk about it later. This is www.lebanity.gov.lb. This is the website of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. This is an official site, so you can visit it and fill your application, and you will have the answer within 24 or 48 hours. We'll make many tests about it together next week. The rights, so why we promote registration? How do we benefit from the Lebanese citizenship? You will benefit from the right to vote. The first right is the right to vote, the right to own properties without paying taxes, high taxes, the right to invest and establish business in Lebanon, the right to enjoy a low tax environment, and we'll talk about it later too, the right to benefit from banking secrecy, and now it's very important for all of you to have this right, and the right to live in Lebanon and work in Lebanon permanently without any complications, the right to free education, because we have public schools in Lebanon, and social security, free social security in Lebanon. Especially for you who are living now abroad, you will have the right to consular assistant if needed. If you need anything as Lebanese, you have the Lebanese ID, the Lebanese consulate should take you in charge. You will ask whatever you need from the consulate. This is the law, this is the constitution. So if you have the Lebanese ID, wherever you are living, you can benefit from the right consular rights. You should know also that you have the right to have the dual citizenship, your actual nationality, and the Lebanese. And we don't have any more compulsory military service. It was abolished in 2055, and the registration process is free of charge at all levels. You don't pay a penny if you ask for your Lebanese citizenship. We'll take in charge everything. The foundation, the Minister of Interior, the Minister of Foreign Affairs will take in charge all the expenses of the citizenship. Okay? So, as you can see, Lebanon is proud of you, so please be proud of Lebanon, love Lebanon, and be proud of Lebanon. Any question, but quick question, because I want to give the floor to Anthony before he goes to the airport. As I told you, as you have seen in the program, we have a workshop of two hours, to know how you get your Lebanese citizenship, or anyone of your family, or your relatives, or neighbors, or anything. No questions? I can give the floor to Anthony Cantara. Anthony Cantara is from the 2015 class of the Maronite Academy. 2 years ago, he was with us. When he went back to his country, he told me, he wrote to me, he told me that it changed his life. When he came here, he used to hear about Lebanon, but he never lived Lebanon as he had done it with us. So when he went back to his country, he decided to launch a website, special website, called The 1961. And this website, the objective of this website is to promote Lebanon, focusing mostly on the good things in Lebanon. So this website has quickly grown. He started in 2016, he will tell you about it. It has quickly grown to become one of the leading English media sites catered to the Lebanese audience. In 3 months, the website received 1.8 million views. The articles have been shared widely by Lebanese and foreign politicians and linked to by major international media sites. The website of Anthony helped promoting the Maronite Academy and encouraging people to sign up at the Maronite Academy and announcing the winners. Your names were in the website of Anthony. So Anthony, the floor is for you, and I will really enjoy your presentation.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for the introduction. So I didn't fully prepare. It was kind of last minute, and the flight over here was pretty hectic. I arrived last night, so bear with me. So,
closer.
Okay, hi. And another thing, I hate public speaking. I absolutely hate it. So I hope you guys bear with me. So I was part of the 2015 class. Go a little bit back. So I used to live here up until 2008 for about 5 years. And then I had to leave for family reasons. And it was always in my mind when I left Montreal. And it's always in my mind that I would one day come back, right? So it was always my plan to come back. This is my house, this is my home. But as the years are going by, it was becoming less and less of a reality. So 6-7 years went by when I came across the Maronite Academy's post that we went a 2-week free all-inclusive trip. I was like, yeah, well, what's the catch? You know, like there's something over here. But I applied anyways, and I heard back from Ziad, who was taking care of the applications in Montreal. And I was one of the winners, so I was selected and I came in 2015. And the trip, even though I had lived here for 5 years, it felt like I was seeing Lebanon for the first time and in a completely different perspective. We got to see places that I've never been to while I was living here. And in my head the whole time, I was like, people living here, there should be a trip just for people living here to go see all these places. Like, there's places I've never been. I've never been to Manshabe, I've never been to Zahle, I've never been to Baalbek, and this is me living over here when I was living here. So it really started to change my mind. The first few days I arrived here, I was just like, no way I can live here. It's too chaotic. It was a huge culture shock. And I remember calling my sister, I'm like, I can't do this. I'm going back, like people don't know how to drive. Like it was pretty crazy. After 3 days, they stopped hearing from me. It was gonna be a 2-week trip. It turned to 2 months, and they almost had to drag me out because I wasn't gonna leave. I quickly started to appreciate the smaller things in Lebanon, like kind of recognizing the issues that existed, but not dwelling on it. So the smallest of things started to push the smallest things. So I was driving with my cousin, for example, and we're just driving that night. I told him like, stop. He's like, what's going on? He pulls over. I get out and I just like, I was looking at the view. Like it was something so simple. He thought it was crazy. He probably still does. But it was something so small that this view I was seeing every day when I was living here, but I just didn't appreciate it. Like, you know, so it's very the small things that kind of started to get to me, you know? So over 2 months, I went back to Montreal, and it kind of stuck with me. I was like, all right, I'm definitely coming back. Like, just how is it going to happen? So I started thinking, how am I going to work for it to come back here? While everyone is leaving, none of my friends are here anymore. They've all left to Dubai, to London for work, and et cetera. So a year went by, and it was always in my mind that I wanted to do something in terms of online. That's my expertise, digital marketing, advertising. And all my other companies and websites were within this, so media, publishing, marketing, advertising. I was like, how can I use that? What am I good at to kind of give back to Lebanon? So about this year, or in July 2016, so last year, I started a blog. It's called The 961. So it plays on the International Code of Lebanon, plus 961. It was English, and at first started, it was just like every now and then I'd write an article. So it was very blog-like, very personal, and just kind of talking about, not experiences, but like basically trying to convince people like you should like Lebanon. Like at first it was like pretty hard, especially with people living here, and they're seeing it firsthand, all the problems, right? And from whether it be corruption to traffic to lack of infrastructure, it's heavy, stuff are heavy. So at first it was hard to resonate, and I knew it wasn't gonna be an easy task, but it was necessary, you know? And we do focus on the positive. So as I'd say, we, because a lot has developed over the past year. So within 3 months, it was just on and off, every article, like every maybe once a week, 2 weeks. And then it started to go on a daily, so at least once a day. And then in November, we had topped the number one blog in terms of traffic. And then we decided to step it up. So now we publish 2 to 3 articles a day, and I have a full-time staff on full-time salary, fully writing content. And they're doing amazing work. We have like a video person as well, taking care of video. So it's grown a lot. And yeah, so the last 3 months, as she said, we had hit 1.8 million views. In March, we were competing with traffic with the leading news websites in Lebanon, English news websites. And at 1 month, we actually surpassed the number one for a bit. And this is only in 1 year. This was less than a year from launching. It's grown phenomenally. And it was always in our focus that concentrate on the positive. Like, no matter how small, like, enough small things can make a big impact. That's how I like to see it. Something very simple, like, there's a project, or the World Bank wants to fund a public transit project, right? We won't cover something that's an idea, but if we see that there's certain work being put into it, we'll put emphasis on it, we'll put the light on it. It was like a public transit system of, I don't know what, a lot of the other websites were kind of, how do I explain it? Kind of playing it down, they're like, made it into a joke, they're like, yeah, like, that's gonna happen. And that infuriates me, because that pessimism is, I believe, keeps us behind. You know, this is what's pulling back a lot. I'm gonna change this conversation so you guys can resonate a little bit more living abroad, but it's huge here that the pessimism is just way too much. And when these supposedly influencers and leaders and bloggers are pushing that kind of mentality of keep pushing Lebanon down, it's, and people are listening to this every day and watching this, it has that effect. So that's what also pushed me to start doing the 961 product, give everything a more positive turn. We will tackle issues, like the negative issues when we need to, like in terms of corruption and stuff, we'll put light on that to deal with it. It's important for us as well. But kind of keep a little brief on track of time. So eventually within our plan, like within this month, we were expanding it. So the 961 itself is all bootstrapped, so we started from nothing. When I started seeing it take it off, I sold one of my main websites and reinvested it into the 961. It's all in for me. I want to make it a mission that I need to give back and do my part. So we're going to launch new sites to take care of the marketing, as well as the direct system for the smaller business to give more light on local businesses as well. And we're going to grow from there. There's an eventual plan to also start offering scholarships to students to see how we can give back to promote entrepreneurship as well within the local, within Lebanon, as well as potentially abroad, depending on how quickly we grow from here. Within our long-term plans, we're probably gonna start touching on outside, so touch on Dubai and Saudi Arabia on a different, completely different website, but with the 961 being its main, the main goal to help us achieve our goals. The trip, sorry. She's like waiting for it. Yeah, so the trip was absolutely amazing. Like it's the first couple of days, like I said, it was tough. Like it wasn't easy. I was just like, I think when you live abroad, and especially when you leave, you start to like Lebanon. Like I was saying, you start liking the smaller things, you start missing the smaller things. And a lot of the community, especially in Montreal when I was there at the time, it's very strong. The Lebanese community is really strong. It's very active. And I would say that they're probably more Lebanese than a lot of Lebanese over here. a sense that the traditions, the values, the culture. So it was easy to kind of keep connected, but also being abroad. But when you come here, a lot of that image is broken down quickly. Especially as soon as you're like getting out the airport, you're stuck in the traffic, you're seeing the way people drive, you're just like, what's going on over here? And I think that was my thing. I was talking to the taxi driver bringing me from the airport, and we were discussing this. Any opportunity I'm talking about it and getting people's input. And we're talking how Lebanon truly has something unique. I'll stand by this till the end of my time, that we truly, truly have something unique that I haven't seen anywhere in the world, especially when it comes, like, to touch on it with coexistence. Like, we live here, Lebanese Christians, of course, there's been difficulties in the past, but you're able to talk and debate and change ideas without any animosity. This doesn't exist abroad. Like, you can't bring up something, especially here, like, a lot of you can vouch for, especially when you're in Canada, I know it's experience. You'll be like, oh yeah, I'm Christian. People look at you sideways, and this is, you know, a country like Canada, like, well, Christian, oh, it means you're this, you're that, you're this. It's weird. It's like, you wouldn't assume for supposedly a Christian majority country. But when you come to Lebanon, you're a Christian, they'll be like, all right, cool. Like, you don't know why you're telling that. It's so normal, right? And same thing, like, we can discuss topics easily with other religions or lack of religions or insult people back and forth, but then the conversation just naturally switches to something else, and there's no animosity, there's no, like, hatred that's dwelled on. And I think that's kind of what's what I'm liking and what I want to push to keep going as well.
Please tell them how they can do to benefit the maximum from their
interview. Make the best of it. It's very quick. The 2 weeks will pass by very, very fast. It's almost like an intensive course. It's like a 2 week intensive course, but you'll be traveling like all over, like, very fast. You're gonna feel really tired, but take every moment you can, enjoy it, and the nice moments of it, like cherish them. And because it's gonna stay with you for the rest of your life. And I always credit the Academy, my trip to the Academy, for launching the 961, for, like, reigniting my love for Lebanon. And it sounds very weird, but, like, I do love Lebanon, and believe it or not, it's something almost controversial, like, to say, and I've come under attack by it because... Hello? All right. I've come under attack because I've said, oh, yeah, I love Lebanon. But I truly do. It's something you should cherish. And when you go back, see how you can do your part to promote it. And there's just one thing I want to touch on. So right now, I'm not sure if you guys are following. We're basically, Canada's trying to push, Air Canada's trying to push for direct flights from Canada to Beirut. And the government's been pushing it down every time for security reasons. But last week, I was in touch with one of the execs at Air Canada who got in touch with me, trying to see how we can, how I can do my part to kind of push and help lobby to have Canada, the government of Canada, completely change its, like, position and allow this. So this is something that directly affects, and it's something small that started, like, here, but here I am, probably saying a meeting with the Prime Minister to kind of push for this. Maybe something small.
Maybe you can make a petition on your website.
We've done
to ask for the Lebanese airlines.
Absolutely. But it's true, like, and that was our main focus, is we want to get as much eyes on it, and that's why they wanted to reach out. And it's something small that you never know when they're gonna need your help for whatever reason, or never know when Lebanon's gonna need your help, and that's kind of your role, or that's something you can do. I'm good. Does anyone have any questions?
Yeah.
Hi. So the 961.com. So it's within the plans eventually to kind of localize as well, like, within communities. So we have a lot of content that's geared towards Lebanese Canadians, like just things that you would relate to, Lebanese Australians, Lebanese in the States. Surprisingly, our most active community is the Lebanese living in the States, and I didn't expect that at all. And there's eventual plans to see it, how it grows, localized in Brazil, localized in Latin America as well. But yeah, it's the 961.com. Felt like a Kanye moment, and my mic taken off. I think the biggest thing, and that's why it resonated with people, is that we started to focus, like, I feel people are getting suffocated by such bad news. You know, it's always constant negativity about Lebanon. But a lot of people had it in them, they're like, oh, you know, I like Lebanon, at least to a certain degree. I don't want this constant negativity. So I think that's what resonated, and that's why we were able to grow so fast. And I'm almost shocked that here I am 1 year later, 1.8 million views. We've reached millions of people since the year. I think it was like 3.5 million people who check out the website, and it's about half of them keep coming back. So it's, I think, just the positivity, focusing on the positivity. And we started to see a lot of the other websites start to change their angle and start saying, like, oh, we want to talk about positivity, which is good, which is, it works for what I want as well, and promote Lebanon. Anything else?
Any more question? Any question?
Hey.
Okay, you mentioned the direct flights from Canada to Lebanon. What is the status on that? And you mentioned that there's, like, security reasons?
Yeah, so it was refused, but they're not giving us more information. So it's coming now out of the Prime Minister's office. It's his direct choice now, which is surprising because you'd assume he'd be someone who would want to back something like this. They're citing national security, Canadian national security reasons, but it doesn't, like, our argument that it doesn't make sense. They're having direct flights to countries that are a lot worse off, and it's borderline insulting that they're allowing flights directly to those countries and not to Lebanon. But it's been refused, the latest as of 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago. But the Air Canada is investing a lot into trying to change that as well. And then the Lebanese Chamber of Commerce in Nova Scotia is working as well with it on it. And we're kind of mobilizing the community to make it happen. Another fact is that British Airways, Lufthansa, Air France, they all fly direct here. And they leave their airplanes here overnight with airport security guarding it. So it's such a non-issue. Any other questions? Awesome. Thank you.